Haggai, Citigroup Investment Bank has made a prediction that inflation will hit 18.6% next year. And who will be in charge when it reaches that level? Liz Truss. Now, she's likely to take over from Boris Johnson at number 10, and her solution to this problem, the problem of rampant inflation, is to cut taxes. Boris Johnson's sister Rachel spoke to economist and political scientist Geoffrey Sander from King's College London about what 18.6% inflation would actually look like, and his forecast is pretty grim. Have a listen.
Surprised by this forecast or not?
I am pretty surprised. I mean, it's a shocking set of figures, and it really kind of spells out what we face in this country. And it's not just a crisis now, it is a catastrophe. You know, look, the average family, after kind of tax and everything, is about £40,000 in their pocket. This level of price increase of 18.6%, even with a pay rise, will leave them £4,500 worse off. Let's make no mistake, this will be a catastrophe. Middle class families are going to go to the war. We're going to see more business bankruptcies than we saw during the pandemic. And we're going to see a wave of starvation unseen since the 1930s. And we should remember that already 2.6 million kids in this country are going hungry. That's what will happen if inflation is allowed to get to 18.6%. Now, households can't stop that happening. Families can't stop that happening. But government can absolutely get us through this moment, freeze energy prices, increase universal credit, and also use the next year to make sure we're not in this situation again, insulate our homes and get us to renewables. We need the government to do that, and whoever the Prime Minister is to do that as soon as they come into office.
But unfortunately, I don't think Liz Truss is going to do that. Liz Truss, of course, is more likely than Rishi Sunak to take over. She has some sort of plan, although she hasn't run it past the Office for Budget Responsibility, the OBR. Now, the OBR are normally responsible for presenting figures for the future to the Chancellor, whoever he or she is. Liz Truss is not relying on the OBR figures, so she's basically pulling them out of her behind. This is not the way to deal with the cost of living crisis. You need to be looking at real figures and having a plan based on real figures. Yes, they're only forecasts, but they are the best that you have. And what's really concerning, also mentioned here by the guest, was there's going to be a wave of starvation not seen since the 1930s if this rise of inflation hits 18.6%. Starvation not seen since the 1930s, just after the Great Depression and before World War II. Something has to be done. Tax cuts are not going to make any real difference. And Liz Truss's plan to remove the Green Levy, which of course is there to help insulate homes in the future, is creating another problem later on down the road. And it doesn't help people, really. We're talking about a very small percentage of the overall bill, because the vast majority of the bill today is the rise in energy prices. So a real package, a stimulus package, needs to be presented. If it's necessary to borrow or to raise taxes on people who can afford it, obviously the multinational corporations and the mega rich, tax them who can afford it, who don't really feel the impact, and use it to create a stimulus package for ordinary people. Now, of course, nationalizing some of these industries would help as well. It would protect the public in the long term as well. While a stimulus package would be good for 6 months or a year, you're going to probably need another one in 2023. But 18.6%, as he said, is going to create massive disruption. It's not just a crisis, it's a catastrophe. And you're going to see more and more businesses close and a recession, of course, as a result of that. Let me know in the comment section, guys, what you think. As always, your comments are greatly appreciated. Thanks a lot.